Welcome to Swift Nature Camp. In this session, we're going to talk a little bit about healthcare and our camp. At Swift Nature Camp, we do have an RN on staff. She's there 24 hours a day, and her responsibilities include looking around camp for any unsafe conditions. We actually have a program where campers help us with this and get rewarded. It's called the Safety Eyes Program, and if they see something that maybe a nail or something sticking out or something like that, they'll mention it and bring it to her, and then they'll get rewarded for that. The nurse's responsibility is also to in emergency sorts of situation, help us deal with those, take care of us for normal care, like cuts and bruises and scrapes and those sorts of things, tummy aches, and then dispensing meds, which happens whenever the appropriate time may be.
If your child has medication that they will be bringing to camp, please make sure that they are in their original bottles with doctor's names and the dosage prescribed. All medication will be kept at the nurse's office, and only she will be dispensing them at the appropriate time to your child.
Under lock and key.
Yes, definitely. It's all locked. There is a way that you can make our nurse's life a little easier. And on Camp Doc, where you get your health form, there is a way that you can order medication that will be prepackaged and sent to our camp with your child's name, the time when the meds should be given, the name of the meds, and the dosage. And it's all packaged for every single dosage. That makes the life of our nurse so much easier. And and it helps avoid mistakes that we don't want
to
happen.
Yeah, it certainly makes it safer that in one package is three pills for your child, which are all for, let's say, breakfast or whatever the case may be. Also, inhalers and EpiPens, those aren't kept at the health center unless you have a backup. Those are kept with the child or the counselor, depending on the age of the child and or the counselor. In our health center, we do have many over-the-counter medications and drugs. And so if your child is accustomed to getting one of those for some reason, you can certainly send them along, but generally you don't need to. We have those things in our health center and provide those to children on an as-needed basis.
If a situation comes up that the nurse needs to take the camper to a doctor, we'll definitely give you a call and she'll explain what's happening. And once at the doctor or after doctor visit, we'll contact you again to keep you in the loop.
At camp, we do have some things that are not unusual to the outdoors. One, of course, is the sun, and so the best preventative to get sunburnt and have skin damage is sunscreen. We do encourage children daily to put on their sunscreen, so you may want to send that along as well.
With younger children, the counselors often make sure that before they leave for activity, everybody has sunscreen on, and that also happens with older children too.
Ticks. We have ticks in the North Woods. Yeah, they're little pesky bugs that suck your blood, and that's not so bad. But some of them, the real tiny ones, do have Lyme disease. We do have Lyme disease where we are. Is it a big issue? Not really. The key is that ticks always travel up, and so you'll find them in your hairline potentially. You may find them in warm places. So we frequently do tick checks in the cabin. We have counselors sponsor these, and kids work together and independently to make sure that they don't have ticks. Just to let you know, there is an antibiotic for ticks, and if in fact you do get Lyme disease, you take 3 of these antibiotic and you're done. So it's not a life-changing situation unless it has not been found out and is in your body for a long period of time. Lice. Tell us about lice, Lonnie.
Oh my gosh, yes. Lice can happen at camp. You know, they happen at school and they may happen at camp. We've had pretty good record of not having lice at camp, but I think we need to talk about it. It's important that if your child, for whatever reason, brings lice from school, please make sure they go to camp without lice. And if that happens, we, our nurse checks every camper. Once they get to camp, we have a health check, and one of the things that she checks for is for lice. So once that's caught, we would take care of that in a health center, obviously in a way that your camper would not feel embarrassed, because it's never fun to be the one with lice. And our goal is to send your child home without lice. But please make sure that when your child arrives home, just check their hair.
Yeah, we've rarely have lice, but we know that it's a more and more common situation, and we've had friends in the camping industry that many of their children have gone home with lice. So we have been really lucky. We work at it hard. And please help us with that. So if you know something, let us know in advance. That's so important so that we can continue to maintain and stop it. We've had a few parents along the way that haven't told us that, and that's been kind of a nightmare. It's kind of like, oh, your child knew but didn't say anything, and the parents didn't say anything. So again, it's really important that you give us that information. I have to tell you that probably the number one item that we prescribed out of our health center is water. Mm-hmm. We try to get our children to drink. They're moving all day, they're outside, it can be warm. And so dehydration and just getting very thirsty can have its effects on children, from a headache to just being tired to whatever the case may be. So 90% of the time we tell children, go drink this bottle of water, and if you continue to have an issue, come on back, and it does wonders. So make sure you have a really good water bottle that you send with your child to camp. What else about healthcare? If your child has any dental issues, please try to get those up to speed quickly so that your child wouldn't need to go during camp. There is an orthodontist about 30 miles away, and we can schedule an appointment, but sometimes it can take a week for us to get in. We do have wax for those orthodontist problems that happen, so we can stick some wax on there in the short term, but try to make sure that it's all taken care of in advance. Eyeglasses. If your child wears eyeglasses, try to send a second pair. They can get lost. Our son has even lost his before. So having a second pair at least gives you that backup and gets you ready for that. The last thing I want to mention is meds that you might be sending with your child, or over-the-counter medications, or things that really need to go to the health center. If you're sending by bus or coming, please make sure that those get to one of our camp adults, either a camp counselor or a camp nurse. If you're sending your child by plane or whatever, make sure that those are neatly contained someplace with a big note on it, hand the counselor, so that those can get taken right away up to the health center and be put in its proper place. Well, I think that's about it for healthcare. If you have specific questions that have to deal with your child, please feel free to give us an email at swiftcamp@aol.com, or you can in fact give us a jingle and we'll try to call you back. So,
and the more information we have, the easier it'll be to provide an excellent experience for your child.
All right, thanks.
Hi.
Bye now.